You know by now that there are two primary navigational tabs at the top of every GreenGlass screen, Collection and Analysis. To access the Analysis page, click here. You will land on the Overview, which displays a list of your saved queries. The results of each query appear here, and the parameters of each query appear in the center of the screen. On the far right, you'll find the options to edit, clone, or delete each query. Note that you can only see your own saved queries. There is no embedded feature for sharing queries with your colleagues. Until we develop that feature, we suggest that a screenshot of the saved query can serve the same purpose. For now, we will click on the New Query button to build one from scratch. From elsewhere in the application, the Query Builder can also be accessed here. As you can see, the Query Builder is divided into two panels. Query parameters are entered in the left panel, and results appear on the right. As changes are made in the left panel, the right panel fades and then refreshes, so the specific impact of each threshold can be seen immediately. The point here is that you can experiment freely with any number of possible scenarios. As you enter parameters, they will appear in the right panel, under the tallies, and above the bar chart. Before building a query, you'll want to be familiar with the available components, some of which have been customized for your library. After naming your query, you will have the opportunity to select all subjects, specific LC classes, or even specific LC subclasses. If yours is a Dewey library, you'll also have the opportunity to select specific Dewey ranges at the level of hundreds or tens. You'll have the opportunity to select specific locations or all locations. You can also control your results by primary language. Simply enter the three-letter code from the MARC record. If you wish to include multiple languages, separate the codes with commas. If your library has chosen to include government documents, non-books, and/or scores, those formats can be isolated here. You'll have the opportunity to set usage thresholds for recorded uses and last charge date, publication year, and date added to the collection. You'll have the opportunity to set several overlap thresholds based on WorldCat holdings data. These will include U.S. or Canadian holdings, state or province holdings, and a variety of comparator library holdings based on the groups that were established for your library at the outset of the project. You can also control query results based on HathiTrust status, special categories, and choice designators. At the very bottom of the list, there is an opportunity to combine the on-screen query with one or more saved queries. For an OR operation, choose the Combine option. For an AND operation, choose Intersect. Now we'll scroll back to the top of the left panel and build a sample preservation scenario. We will seek to identify materials that are scarcely held and which the library may want to digitize, preserve, or protect on behalf of the collective collection. Remember to confirm your query name here. We'll include all subjects, all locations, and all formats. We'll ignore local circulation history and age of materials and head straight for WorldCat holdings. If we want to identify content that is scarcely held, we can choose any edition matching for titles held by fewer than 5 libraries in the U.S. We'll further restrict the results by choosing to include only those items that are not held in HathiTrust. In the right panel, we can see that the number of matched items is 8,059, which represents 1.4% of the entire collection. Now, let's build a sample query to identify potential withdrawal candidates. Here again, we will include all subjects, all locations, and all formats. Let's set the threshold for recorded uses at fewer than 2. Let's also say that we only want to consider for withdrawal books that are more than 5 years old and added to the collection more than 5 years ago. We'll only consider titles that are held by more than 100 libraries in the U.S. and that are not unique in the state. At this point, we can see that 64,336 items match the requirements of the query, or 11.1% of the entire collection. The green portion of each subject bar on the chart represents items that match the parameters entered so far. And of course, additional thresholds could be added. You can save a query at any time by clicking on the Save button in the upper right corner of the screen. Whether or not you have saved the query, you can scroll down the page to view the charted data in tabular form, and further still to see a list of books that match the current parameters. Because the list may be long, we've included a navigational tool so you can jump into the list by subject. As always, you are free to export the list by clicking on the Export button here. Before signing off, we want to acknowledge that there are still limits to the complexity of queries that can be built in GreenGlass. Please know that your SCS liaisons, Andy Breeding and Ruth Fisher, have more sophisticated query tools at their disposal and will be happy to develop additional scenarios and lists offline. Don't hesitate to send questions or requests as needs arise. In the meantime, we hope you enjoy exploring your collection through this GreenGlass lens, and we welcome your feedback.